this drawing is given separate to the manufacturer, this drawing will be given to the manufacturer, this is a bolt which you are going to buy from outside as a ready-made part. So all these three parts, they are made, they are available, so you bring them. Now when you assemble, when the time of assembly comes, when you assemble, what will happen? You have aligned everything, now it is the time for putting the bolt from where you will put it. There is no space available. Suppose this is open, it is not there, it is open, then you can put it. But then there is some kind of a cover that is there in the design as a requirement. Now that is coming in the way, you cannot do this, although everything else is correct, but you are not taken into account assembly, how you will assemble or how you will dismantle also, both the things. So what modification you will have to do here is, maybe you will have to provide some kind of a cutout here, some kind of a hole is here is provided through which you can pass on the bolt and then you can operate that bolt. Even still, although after doing this, if you show a bolt as a hexagonal bolt, then again it will be correct or not correct. You have taken into account that assembly is required, so you have provided a space here, provided a hole here, and then you feel everything is done, but your drawing shows that this is a hexagonal bolt you expect here. Now what it means? Hexagonal bolt is to be clamped using a spanner. Now here, how you will operate this with a spanner? Not possible. So again there is a difficulty. So again, still the problem of assembly is not taken into consideration. So what is the solution here? The solution will be to provide a bolt of what type? You know what is Allen bolt? You must have seen Allen bolt. Here there is a hexagonal cutout. And then there is a key, say something like this. You must have seen such kind of a key, whose cross section is hexagon. Cross section is hexagon. So using such kind of a hexagonal key and a Allen bolt or Allen screw, which has got a similar hexagonal groove here. So this Allen key, this end of the Allen key of this size, of course I have not drawn with same size, but this end will fit here, size is same, and then you can operate this particular bolt from outside. You can clamp it from outside because it is Allen bolt and it is not an hexagonal bolt. Okay, so these are all the things, all the examples of the fact that you have to take into account the assembly also while designing the components. Then the next is machine maintenance. And servicing. Now again, this is again simple factor. The machine, once you are having a machine, the machine needs to be serviced, it needs to be maintained. Okay, certain kind of maintenance activity is involved when the machine is performing on the say regular basis. So you have to provide some kind of oil, you have to replace certain parts, etc. So that is what is called as a servicing or maintenance. And for maintenance, you have to think about maintenance also while doing the component design. That means, suppose there is a system where oiling is required, then there should be some facility so that oiling is possible. Either it is in built-in facility or from outside you are supplying oil. If you happen to see a sewing machine where we are stitching these clothes, you must have seen this. So sewing machine has again got a lot of parts which are moving, which needs to be oiled. So at certain places on a sewing machine, you can see certain holes are shown and they are also marking the oil. That means from here you put the oil, here you put the oil. So from those holes, if you provide, supply some few drops of oils, then those oil drops will go to the necessary places inside the machine, inside the sewing machine, and then it will function properly. Because the facility is provided, the maintenance is taken into account in the design, and accordingly the instructions or the holes or whatever is required, that is done. So that is taking into consideration the maintenance aspect which is involved in the design. So we are talking about what are the different aspects which you are supposed to take into consideration while doing the design work. So we have discussed few such points which are a must. The designer has to keep these points in mind when the design procedure is applied. Okay. Now let's see the next part.